Torej, mogoče z mal šaljivim, oziroma mal bolj lahkotno vprašanje, oziroma kar dve. Ste pred bogoslovjem imeli punco in ste kdaj bili v skušnjavi poželenja?
Did you ever lust? Did you ever have a girlfriend?
Girlfriend, and if you were ever tempted by lust.
Okay, I'll start with this first question. Did I ever have a girlfriend? I did. Now, you got to know, I came from a North American culture.
Torej, če začnemo kar s tem prvim vprašanjem, ali ste kdaj imeli punco, torej prihaja iz severnoameriškega okolja,
which has something very good.
V katerem je nekaj zelo dobrega.
It's called the culture of dating.
In temu rečemo kultura zmenkov, zmenkarije.
I think it's very healthy to go on dates.
In on meni, da je zelo zdravo hoditi ven na zmenke.
Okay, I think high school children should not have girlfriends. Or boyfriends.
Se pravi, fanti in punce v srednji šoli ne bi smeli imeti fantov pa punc.
They should go on dates.
Morali bi hoditi ven na zmenke.
To get to know each other.
Da bi se med seboj spoznali.
I had a girlfriend before I entered the Salesians.
In preden se je pridružil Salesijancem, bi tudi on imel dekle.
She was French.
Bila je francozinja.
Her name was Sophie.
Ime je bilo Sophie.
From Bayonne, southern France.
Iz juga Francije.
I met her at World Youth Day 1991.
In spoznala sta se na svetovnem srečanju mladih leta 1991.
I was 18, she was 16.
On je bil star 18, ona pa 16.
At the train station in Strasbourg.
In na železniški postaji v Strasbourgu.
I had to go to Paris.
Je moral on iti v Paris.
She had to go to Lyon.
Ona pa v Lyon.
And I asked her to marry me in the train station.
In na železniški postaji jo je prosil, če bi se poročila z njim.
After knowing each other for 2 weeks.
Potem, ko sta se poznala 2 tedna.
And I told her I loved her.
In je povedal, da jo ljubi.
And I told her finish high school.
In je rekel, da naj konča srednjo šolo.
And I will marry you.
In se bom poročil s teboj.
And we wrote to each other for 2 years.
In 2 leti sta si pisala.
And when she graduated.
In ko je res končala srednjo šolo.
She got on a plane.
Je šla na letalo.
She came to Canada.
In prišla v Kanado.
And she wanted to find out.
In je želela izvedeti,
if I was serious.
Če je resen.
By then,
ampak takrat,
God and Don Bosco captured my heart.
Sta Bog in Don Bosco že ujela njegovo srce.
And we had a very, very tearful and difficult departure.
In razšla sta se zelo na težak in način, ki je bil poln solza.
But I couldn't go against my vocation.
Ampak nekako ni mogel se zoprstaviti temu močnemu klicu, ki ga je imel v sebi.
It was burning in my bones.
In to ga je žgalo do kosti.
That doesn't mean that I don't love her.
To ne pomeni, da je ni imel rad in da je ne ljubi.
My spiritual guide told me.
Je duhovni voditelj mu je povedal,
that a true priest,
da pravi duhovnik,
is one that could love a woman.
Je tisti, ki je zmožen ljubiti žensko.
So anyways, yeah, I had a girlfriend.
Torej, ja, itak, imel sem punco.
In terms of lust,
ali pa drugo vprašanje glede poželenja,
I have problems with lust just like anyone else does.
Težave s poželenjem imam tako kot vsak drug človek.
Yesterday,
včeraj,
today,
danes,
and I know tomorrow too.
In jutri zagotovo tudi.
Because lust is part of my fallen nature.
Ker je poželenje del človekove padle narave.
But I fight against lust.
Ampak se proti temu borim.
And I battle it.
In jo zmagujem.
Knowing that it will end.
Ker vem, da se bo nekoč nehala.
As Saint Francis de Sales says.
Kot je rekel sveti Frančišek Saleški.
10 minutes after my death.
10 minut po smrti.
Okay.
Se bo ta strast oziroma poželenje nehala.
But I want to stress there's something more powerful.
Ampak rad bi pa poudaril nekaj bolj pomembnega.
And that's the saving power of Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit.
Ampak to je ta odrešilna in odrešujoča moč Jezusa Kristusa in Svetega Duha.
Okay, let's go on.
To je močnejše od poželenja.
Naslednje vprašanje, oziroma nekaj vprašanje o pornografiji. Kakšen je pogled cerkve na pornografijo in pa še eno bolj konkretno, kaj ko nekoga vidimo pri gledanju pornografije, na primer starše cimre, kako se soočiti s tem?
Okay. I mostly speak to my brothers in Christ tonight.
nocoj govorim predvsem prijateljem, bratom v Kristusu.
Because pornography is a huge problem with men.
Ker je pornografija velika težava predvsem za može, za
even
moške.
Even though some girls have the problem too.
Čeprav se tudi nekatera dekleta srečujejo s to težavo.
20 minutes of pornography
20 minut pornografije
takes 20 years to get out of your head.
Traja 20 let, da spraviš to ven iz svoje glave.
Okay, so listen.
Poslušajte.
What I would say about pornography is that it perverts our image of woman.
O pornografiji lahko rečemo le to, da spervertira našo podobo ženske.
And it reduces woman to an object.
In žensko zreducira, zmanjša na objekt.
And I'm really afraid for these new generations coming up now.
In se zelo bojim za vse te nove generacije, ki prihajajo, ki odraščajo danes.
Because I'm a child of the 80s.
Ker kot otrok 80-ih let,
before my conversion,
pred spreobrnenjem,
I probably saw pornography 3 times in my life.
Je pač videl pornografijo verjetno nekako 3-krat v življenju.
I was probably grade 7 or 8.
Tam nekje v 7. 8. razredu.
There was about 20 of us guys.
Je bilo približno 20 fantov na kupu.
And one of my friends took a magazine from his older brother.
In eden od prijateljev je svojemu starejšemu bratu zasegu.
And he would show everyone like this.
In jo je kazal takole, ne?
Now?
Zdaj?
Today?
Danes?
24 hours.
V 24 urah?
Free.
Zastojn?
All the time.
Na mobilu ves čas.
We're not aware.
Ne zavedamo se
of the horror,
kakšna grozota
and destruction
in kakšno uničenje
of pornography
se dogaja s pornografijo.
It is destroying the hearts of men.
Uničuje srca moških.
So I ask all men here,
zato prosim in pravim vsem možem tu,
to fight a good battle,
da se borite v tej bitki.
If you have the temptation,
če vas obhajajo skušnjave,
throw the computer out of your room.
Vršte računalnik ven iz sobe.
In fuga salvis.
In fula salvis.
Salvation is in run in
se pravi,
v spasu je bijeg. Bijeg je v spasenju.
Se pravi, v begu je rešito. Tako, tako. Pobegnite stran od te stvari.
Ok. Another thing.
Še nekaj drugega.
Install a filter on your computer if you have the problem.
Če se srečujete s to težavo, si na računalnik namestite filter.
I wish you had a clean heart.
Želim si, da bi imeli čisto srce.
So that you could be in front of the computer.
Da bi lahko bili pred računalnikom.
Without the temptation.
Brez, da bi se pojavila ta skušnjava.
But if temptation is too strong.
Ampak če je skušnjava premočna.
Avoid the near occasion of sin.
Se temu grehu izognite.
Okay, there's a wonderful program in America.
V ZDA, v Združenih državah, obstaja čudovit program,
called Covenant Eyes,
ki se mu reče oči zaveze,
where you install a search engine on your computer,
kjer si na računalnik namestite iskalnik,
and the moment you go on porn,
in v trenutku, ko se pač z računalnikom odpravite iskat pornografske strani,
your girlfriend gets a notification on her cell phone.
Dobi vaša žena ali pa punca obvestilo na svoj telefon.
Or your priest,
ali vaš duhovnik,
some of my cousins,
nekateri od njegovih bratrancov,
as soon as they go on porn,
takoj ko grejo gledat pornografijo,
it goes to their kapelan, their priest,
gre obvestilo k njihovem kaplanu,
he calls them up,
takoj jih pokliče,
and he kicks his ass
in jim spraširiti.
Okay, what I want to say is you can't fight alone.
Kar bi rad povedal je to, da se proti temu zlu ne moreš boriti sam.
So every time you go on porn,
vsakič, ko greš gledat pornografijo,
go to confession immediately.
Pojdi takoj po tem k sveti spovedi.
Even if you go every day,
pa čeprav je treba to narediti vsak dan.
Until you root that poison out.
Dokler ne izkoreniniš tega zla iz svojega življenja.
If it means every day of standing in front of your priest embarrassed with your face all red,
če pomeni, da boš ves rdečeličen vsak dan stal pred svojim duhovnikom,
that's what it means.
Je to pač to.
Until you root that poison out.
Dokler ne izkoreniniš iz svojega življenja tega strupa.
Okay, I have problems where students that I work with, girls,
imam težave, kjer študenti, ko delamo s puncami, dekleti,
saw that their father is going on porn.
In ta dekleta so videla, da njihovi očetje gledajo pornografijo, ko so odraščala.
They're devastated.
In te punce so razrvane, so uničene.
I know one girl,
eno dekle,
when she was grade 8,
ki je bila v 8. razredu.
She saw her father was on porn.
Je videla očeta, kako gleda pornografske strani.
It was so difficult for her.
Je bilo to zanjo tako zelo težko.
She was so traumatized.
In je bila zaradi tega tako traumatizirana.
She lost her menstruation.
Da je prenehala menstruacija.
She never got it back.
In nikoli se ji ni povrnila.
Dear brothers,
dragi bratje,
when you go on porn,
ko greste gledati pornografske strani,
you affect everyone around you.
S tem vplivate prav na vse okrog vas.
I know it's your dirty little secret.
Vem, da gre tukaj samo za vašo umazano.
You think no one knows.
Pa da nobeden ne ve.
You think no one, it affects no one.
Mislite, da se to nikogar ne tiče?
But it affects everyone.
Ampak v bistvu se tiče prav vseh.
The problem of porn, and I'll finish this question with this. The problem with porn,
zaključujem s tem odgovorom, težava s pornografijo,
is not that it shows too much.
Ni v tem, da pokaže preveč.
Shows too little.
Pokaže premalo.
Doesn't show the human person.
Ne pokaže osebe, ne pokaže človeka.
It only shows the body.
Samo telo vam pokaže.
Doesn't show the soul.
Duše pa ne.
So I ask my brothers in Christ,
zato bratje v Kristusu,
to never give up that fight.
Vas prosim, da se nikoli ne vdate v tem boju.
Tell someone.
Povejte komu.
Go to confession.
Pejte k spovedi.
Fasting.
Postite se. Post.
On bread and water.
Kruh in voda.
Because if you learn to say no,
če se naučite reči ne,
then you can say yes.
Potem, ko se človek nauči reči ne, potem je zmožen tudi reči
if you can't say
ja.
No,
če se pa ne moreš ničemu odpovedati,
so if you can't say no,
če ne moreš reči ne,
your yes means nothing.
Potem tudi tvoj da ne pomeni nič.
Fasting, bread and water is very helpful.
Post ob kruhu in vodi je zato zelo koristen.
Because you're saying no.
Ker s tem, ko rečeš ne hrani,
to that which is so essential.
Ki je tako bistvena za nas.
Food.
Hrani.
And then you could say no to other things.
Potem lahko rečeš ne tudi drugim stvarim.
The problem with porn is,
težava pri pornografiji je v tem,
you can't say no.
Da v bistvu človek ne more reči.
That's why you have to flex your spiritual muscles.
In zato je treba učvrščevati naše duhovne mišice.
With fasting.
In to se stori s postom.
One last thing about porn.
Še ena zadnja stvar o pornografiji.
Okay, so we got pornography.
Imamo torej pornografijo.
But we got something called virginography.
Imamo pa nekaj, čemur bi se reklo devičografija.
Where you have a picture of the Blessed Virgin Mary.
Kjer imate sliko device Marije.
And when you get the temptation to go on porn,
in kadar vas pograbi ta želja, da bi gledali pornografijo,
take out Mary.
Vzamte ven sliko od Marije.
And look at Mary.
In glejte njo.
And just keep looking at her.
Glejte njeno podobo.
And just keep looking at her.
In še naprej si jo ogledujte.
You will be so embarrassed of what you wanted to do.
Tok zelo vas bo sram tega, kar ste želeli narediti.
Try it.
Poskuste.
Another mechanism.
Še en drug mehanizem.
When you get the urge to go on porn.
Kadar vas poprime ta želja.
Stand up.
Da ustanete.
And do what Jesus did.
In naredite to, kar je naredil Jezus.
Literally, stand up and spread out your arms.
Dobesedno ustanite in dejte roke narazen takole.
And crucify.
In križajte.
The lust.
V sebi to poželenje.
And just stand there.
In stojte tam.
And just stand there.
Kar naprej.
Until it ends.
Ustrajajte, dokler se ne neha.
Okay. Go on.
Okay. Naprej.
Kaj se zgodi, če se ljubita dva, ki nista poročena, in kako ozdraviti rane predzakonske spolnosti? Kaj pa takrat, ko nekdo vara svojega zakonskega partnerja?
And how to heal the wounds of premarital sex. And what happens when someone is cheating on their spouse.
Okay. Well, three basic questions here. Okay, what was the first question?
When two people love each other, they're not married.
Okay. Now, it all depends how you define love.
Torej, vse je odvisno od tega, kako definiramo besedo ljubezen.
If you're a Christian,
če ste kristjan,
if you love as Jesus loves,
če ljubite, kakor je ljubil Jezus, kakor ljubi Jezus,
one characteristic of Christian love is,
ena bistvena značilnost krščanske ljubezni je v tem,
is totality.
Da je tukaj neka totalnost, popolnost.
In Croatian we say trajnost.
Trajnost, okay, se pravi, kaj?
Okay.
Isto, ne?
The problem with two couples that are in love.
Se pravi, za težava pri kakšnemu paru, kjer gre samo za zaljubljenost.
Is they don't have the totality.
Je v tem, da tukaj ni te trajnosti, ni te popolnosti, totalnosti.
Now, the sexual act,
spolno dejanje,
is total self-giving.
Je dejanje popolne predaje samega sebe.
Now, call me crazy.
Pa rečte, da sem nor.
But the language of the sexual act of totally self-giving your body,
ampak to dejanje in jezik tega popolnega samopodaritvenega dejanja
outside of marriage,
izven zakona,
so this is a temporary union,
kjer gre samo za začasno,
is a lie. It's a lie.
V bistvu gre tukaj za eno veliko laž.
What you say with your body of totally self-giving to your girlfriend,
če daš svoje telo popolnoma svoji punci,
does not coincide with your life situation.
V bistvu to ni skladno s tvojo življenjsko situacijo.
Now, I'm not here to point a finger at anyone.
In nismo tukaj zato, da bi s prstom kazali na kogarkoli.
I'm not condemning everyone.
In nikogar ne želimo obsoditi.
I'm just proclaiming the truth.
Ampak želimo jasno povedati resnico.
That sex,
da spolnost,
has to be total.
Mora biti popolno.
Now, physically, when a man enters a woman,
čist na telesnem vidiku, kadar moški vstopi v žensko, ali pa,
that is total.
Gre tukaj za neko popolno predajo.
But if they're not married,
ampak če ta dva nista poročena,
maybe that physical act,
je morda to telesno dejanje,
does not coincide with their situation.
Nekaj, kar se ne sklada z njuno življenjsko situacijo.
Another thing I tell my couples is this.
Še nekaj povem svojim mladim parom.
If you have sex before marriage,
če pred zakonom stopate v spolne odnose,
or let's say sex outside of marriage,
oziroma če vstopate v spolne odnose izven zakona.
Before, outside, same thing.
Pred zakonom ali pa izven zakona gre za isto stvar.
I ask my couples, will sex outside of marriage still be okay when you enter marriage?
Vprašam te mlade ljudi, ali bo tvoja spolnost potem, ko boš vstopil v zakon, še vedno nekaj, kar je okay?
And that's a very good question.
Gre za,
because if sex outside of marriage is good before marriage, why wouldn't it be good in marriage? So that's why infidelity is a huge problem.
Can you somehow
statistically
gledano,
a lot of couples
je veliko parov
that have sex before marriage,
ki imajo spolne odnose pred zakonom,
end up in divorce.
Se najde v ločitvi, se jim zgodi ločitev.
America has the best statistics in Canada.
ZDA in Kanada imajo zelo
almost all divorces.
Vse, skoraj vse ločitve.
The couples that entered, that got divorced, slept with each other before.
Se zgodijo med pari, ki so tudi pred zakonom spali drug z drugim.
Now that doesn't mean that all couples that sleep together before marriage will get a divorce.
To ne pomeni, da se bodo ločili vsi tisti pari, ki so skupaj spali že pred poroko.
But
ampak
over 95% of couples that get divorced slept with each other before marriage.
Ampak dejstvo pa je, da več kot 95% parov, ki se ločijo, je spalo skupaj že pred poroko.
Now, couples that live chastity,
kaj pa pari, ki se zavežejo čistosti?
90% and more stay faithful all life.
Več kot 90% jih ostane zvestih drug drugemu vse življenje.
Ko ima uši, neka čuje.
Kdor ima ušesa, naj sliši.
Okay, what was the second question?
Drugo vprašanje je bilo,
kako ozdraviti rane pred zakonske spolnosti?
How to heal the wounds of premarital sex.
Okay. You know what's another argument that premarital sex is not good?
Veste, kaj je še en argument za to, da predzakonska spolnost v bistvu ni nekaj dobrega?
I still have not met a guy,
še vedno nisem srečal nikogar,
that did not want a virgin,
ki si ni želel imeti
on his first night,
na svojo
first marriage night,
prvo poročno noč.
So, could you imagine, guys, you're getting married? Okay, you get married.
A si predstavljate, fante se poročijo.
And you come into the room for your first wedding night.
In prideš pač v sobo na svojo prvo poročno noč.
And your wife says, you know, honey, I wanted this night to be special.
In ti pač tvoja nova žena reče, veš, dragi, jaz sem si pa želela, da bi bila ta noč nekaj posebnega za nas.
So I had sex with about 10 guys.
Zato sem jaz pred tem spala z približno 10.
So I could perform well for you tonight.
Zato da bi danes začer s tabo lahko dobro opravila.
You say thank you, honey.
In kaj boš rekel, hvala, draga moja.
No. Every single guy I know,
čisto vsak fant, ki ga poznam,
wants a virgin.
Si želi imeti devico.
Why?
Zakaj?
Because that's true, good and beautiful.
Ker je to resnično dobro in lepo.
Every girl I know,
vsako dekle, ki ga poznam,
wishes,
si želi,
that her boyfriend, that she's going to get married,
da bi bil fant, s katerim se bo poročila,
is a virgin.
Devičnik.
Why?
Zakaj?
Because it's true, good and beautiful.
Ker je to nekaj resničnega,
so
dobrega
in lepega. Let's not make idiot of ourselves.
Dej, nehajmo se slepiti in delati bedake
now,
sami sebe.
Because a lot of people have sinned.
Ker je dejstvo, da je mnogo ljudi
and they've slept with other people before.
In so spali z drugimi ljudmi že pred pač zakonom.
We will forgive one another.
Bomo drug drugemu to odpustili. Hvala Bogu.
But deep down,
ampak globoko v sebi.
We all know.
Vsi vemo.
That is true.
Kaj je res?
That we want a virgin. And the guy that tells me that he does not a virgin is a liar. He's lying, he's lying, he's lying.
In tip, ki ti reče, da si ne želi imeti device, je lažnjuc. Laže, laže,
deep
laže.
Down, he wants a virgin.
Globoko v sebi si to res želi.
Admit it.
Priznaj že, no.
And that confirms the teaching of the church.
In to je tisto, kar potrjuje nauk cerkve na tem področju.
Okay, so how to heal this?
Kako pa potem ozdravimo to rano?
Jesus said in the book of Revelation.
Jezus je rekel v Razodetju.
I make everything new.
Glejte, vse delam novo.
Okay, Jesus heals.
Jezus ozdravlja.
He's the same.
On je isti.
Today, yesterday and tomorrow.
Včeraj, danes in jutri.
And I have witnessed.
In tudi sam sem bil priča.
The healing power of Jesus Christ.
Kristusovi ozdravljujoči moči.
Inner healing.
Globoko notranje ozdravljenje.
Prayers of healing.
In tudi priča molitvam za ozdravljenje.
Confession.
Spoved.
And the Holy Spirit.
In Sveti Duh.
So I tell people who have fallen.
In zato lahko povem ljudem, ki so padli.
No, fear not.
Da se naj ne bojijo.
Because when Jesus encounters people in the gospel who have sinned in the area of sexuality.
Ker ko je Jezus se v evangeliji srečeval z ljudmi, ki so grešili na tem spolnem področju.
He shows the utmost mercy.
In pokaže svojo največjo milost.
Why?
Usmiljenje. Zakaj?
Because he knows.
Ker on ve.
That they were looking for him.
Da so v resnici ti ljudje v teh dejanjih iskali njega.
In the wrong way.
Pač na napačen način.
And in the wrong place.
Na napačnem kraju.
That's why he loves them so much.
In ravno zato jih ima tako zelo rad.
He knows they're weak.
Ve, da so šibki.
And they were looking for him.
Ampak ve tudi to, da so iskali njega.
That's why so much mercy towards the Samaritan woman.
Zato Jezus izkaže tolikšno usmiljenje ženi ob vodnjaku, Samarijanki.
And the woman and Mary Magdalene.
In Mariji Magdaleni.
Okay, so fear not.
Zato se ne bat.
Okay, so it's possible to experience the healing of Christ.
Jasno je, da je možno izkusiti Kristusovo ozdravljujočo moč.
Okay, what's the third question?
Kaj pa takrat, ko nekdo vara svojega zakonskega partnerja?
What about healing for the people that
forgiveness.
Se pravi, gre za odpuščanje.
Because you promised on the day of your marriage.
Na dan vajne poroke.
That you will love as Jesus loves.
Sta si obljubila, da bosta ljubila drug drugega tako, kot vaju ljubi Jezus.
And when Jesus handed his life over.
In ko je Jezus predal svoje življenje.
In Gethsemane.
V Getsemaniju.
Peter denied him.
Ga je Peter zanikal, je rekel, da ga ne pozna.
Judas betrayed him.
Juda ga je izdal.
And all the disciples fled.
In vsi apostoli so ga zapustili.
Jesus's bride, the church.
Jezusova nevesta, cerkev.
Cheated on him.
Je v bistvu ga prevarala.
And what did Jesus do?
Ampak kaj je Jezus naredil?
Forgive them, Father, for they not know what they do.
Rekel je, odpusti jim, oče, saj ne vedo, kaj delajo.
I can't proclaim anything else but the gospel of Jesus Christ.
Nič drugega ne morem oznanjati kot evangelija Jezusa Kristusa.
So I tell people to forgive.
Zato pravim ljudem naj odpustijo.
And that forgiveness and that wound can actually become a source of blessing.
In prav to skozi to odpuščanje lahko prav ta rana postane izvir in vir blagoslova.
As the catechism of the Catholic Church teaches on the chapter on forgiveness.
Kakor uči tudi katekizem katoliške cerkve v poglavju o odpuščanju.
Wound can become blessing through forgiveness.
Rana lahko skozi odpuščanje postane blagoslov.
Okay, let's go on.
Še eno vprašanje povezano s tem. Ne morem se strinjati, da je prejem zakramentov za ločene in ponovno poročene smrtni greh, so tudi ločeni brez lastne krivde in pa še ničnost zakona. Kaj pa ničnost zakona?
Okay. Well, it's a very, very It's a question that's very modern today. It's what the whole church is talking about.
Gre torej za zelo sodobno vprašanje, saj dan danes o tem govori celotna cerkev.
We have very tragic situations.
In dejansko imamo v svetu zelo tragične.
Including in my family.
Tragične situacije, vključno z njegovo družino.
I have 26 cousins.
Ma 26 bratrancev.
From one baka.
Od ene babice.
Okay. Okay. And you know, I could write a book about my family.
In od celi te razširjeni družini bi se dal napisati knjigo.
There's about 6 divorces in my family.
In v tej širši družini je 6, se pravi 6 ljudi se ločilo.
It's very painful.
In gre za zelo boleče za stvari.
So I just want to know, I haven't fallen from Mars, okay?
Rad bi vam povedal, da nisem padel z Marsa, pravi.
Okay, but there is a truth.
Ampak obstaja neka resnica.
That on the day of your wedding.
Da na dan svoje poroke.
You promised.
Sta si obljubila.
That you will love one another.
Da bosta drug drugega ljubila.
As Jesus loved.
Kakor je ljubil Jezus.
In good and bad.
V dobrem in v slabem.
In health and sickness.
V zdravju in v bolezni.
And you know Jesus was abandoned.
In veste tudi Jezus je bil zapuščen in so ga zapustili.
It wasn't his fault.
Ni bila njegova krivda.
Carried the cross to the end.
Ni bil sam kriv, pa je vendar nosil križ.
He could have abandoned his bride.
Svojo nevesto bi bil lahko zapustil.
In Getsemani.
V Getsemaniju.
He could have said.
Bi lahko rekel.
I am not going on the cross for my bride.
Za tole svojo nevesto pa jaz že ne grem na križ.
She does not deserve this.
Ona si tega ne zasluži.
She cheated on me.
Goljufala me je.
But he went on the cross.
Ampak kljub temu je šel na križ.
That's what I call love.
Temu pravim ljubezen.
To the end.
In to je ljubezen do konca.
On the day of your wedding.
Na dan vajne poroke.
You promised.
Sta drug drugemu obljubila.
You made a vow.
In se zaobljubila.
Before God.
Pred Bogom.
That you will love.
Da bosta ljubila.
As Jesus loves.
Kakor ljubi Kristus.
You said it.
Rekla sta.
And you know, when you're abandoned and it's not your fault, I know all about that.
Vem, da ko je človek zapuščen, da to ni njegova krivda. Poznam to.
You are called.
Ampak kljub temu je človek poklican.
To follow Jesus.
Da sledi Kristusu.
On the way of the cross.
In tudi po poti križa.
And you will have your place in heaven.
In v nebesih boste imeli svoje mesto.
And obviously a person who remains faithful even though the other side abandoned them.
In očitno se pravi tudi oseba, ki ostane zvesta, čeprav jih je zapustil partner,
can receive communion.
Lahko seveda prejema obhajilo.
But if you enter a new union,
ampak če vstopi v novo zvezo,
you are living in sin.
Pa živi v grehu.
And to receive communion in that state,
in da v tem grešnem stanju prejmeš obhajilo,
it's a contradiction.
Gre tukaj za nasprotovanje.
So I ask you,
zato vas prosim,
to carry your cross,
da nosite svoj križ.
And I tell you it's possible.
In vam povem, da je to tudi možno.
Because for God everything's possible with the help of the Holy Spirit.
Ker skozi moč in pomoč Svetega Duha je za Boga vse možno.
And I want you to pray about that.
In vas vabim, da o tem molite.
Because it's not all about intellect.
Ker tukaj ne gre samo za intelektualni razmislek o teh stvareh.
It's about the heart.
Ampak gre za srce.
So pray that Jesus could soften your heart.
Molite za to, da bi ga Jezus lahko omehčal okay. Vaše srce.
Okay.
To je paničnost.
Sorry?
To je paničnost. Ničnost je še bilo vprašanje.
You know, okay, yeah. That's why the church, the mother church, the church loves us, okay? The church is a mother.
Se pravi, vemo, lejte, cerkev nas ljubi, cerkev je kot mati.
And she knows, the church knows that on the day of the wedding, maybe we weren't capable, maybe we weren't free, maybe something was wrong on the day of the wedding, that's why we have church courts.
Torej, glede ničnosti, govorimo, da cerkev se zaveda, da morda so bile na tisti poročni dan prisotne okoliščine, ko nismo bili zmožni, ko nismo bili svobodni pri tej svoji odločitvi, zato obstajajo tudi cerkvena sodišča.
What an annulment is,
in ničnost zakona je v tem,
what the church says,
da cerkev reče,
there was no marriage.
Da zakona v bistvu v resnici sploh
God
ni bilo.
Did not join them.
Bog te veze ni združil.
So we pronounce this so-called marriage null.
Zato to tako imenovano zakonsko zvezo please, razglasimo za nično.
Yeah. Please take recourse to this.
Prosim, bodite previdni pri tem.
If yeah, please try to if you have reasons, maybe you could get an annulment.
No, in pa tudi glejte, če obstajajo realni razlogi, se morda lahko pač dobi takšna odločitev sodišča, okay. Dobite nično zakona.
Go ahead.
Kar nekaj vprašanja namenjenih temi homoseksualnosti in sicer predvsem tri se ponavljajo. Kakšen načrt ima Bog za ljudi s homoseksualnimi nagnjeni? Ali se oni takšni rodijo, jih je Bog homoseksualne ustvaril in kaj svetovati osebam s takšno spolno usmerjenostjo?
Okay, listen. I'll start with the last question. What do I do with people who have this inclination?
Torej, če začnemo z zadnjim vprašanjem, kaj storiti z ljudmi, ki imajo to vrstno nagnjenje?
I follow several young men in Zagreb.
V Zagrebu spremlja duhovno nekaj mladih fantov,
who are struggling with homosexuality.
Ki se borijo s to vrstnimi nagnjenji homoseksualnosti.
Okay, the first thing.
Prva stvar.
I am led by the Gospel of Matthew.
Me pri tem spremljanju vodi evangelij po Mateju.
First seek the kingdom and its justice and all will be given to you.
Najprej iščite Božje kraljestvo in njegovo pravičnost in vse drugo vam bo navrženo.
So I don't try to heal a homosexual.
Zato ne poskušam ozdraviti homoseksualnosti.
I try to introduce Jesus to him.
Ampak mu želim predstaviti Jezusa.
And Jesus will do two things.
In Jezus bo v življenju te osebe naredil dve stvari.
He'll pour out his spirit upon him and the gift of fortitude so that he could struggle and live a chaste life.
Se pravi, Jezus se bo za to osebo bo mu izlil svojega duha in mu bo dal dar zdržnosti, da bo lahko živel čisto življenje.
Or Jesus will liberate him.
Ali pa ga bo osvobodil.
And give him the power
in mu dal moč
to become what he is.
Da postane to, kar je.
A man.
Moški.
Who loves a woman.
Ki ima rad žensko.
And I have seen this.
In to sem tudi že videl.
So don't believe what the so-called scientists say.
Ne verjeti vsega, kar vam povedo tako imenovani znanstveniki.
That a homosexual.
Da je homoseksualec.
Cannot become what he really is.
Ne more postati tisto, kar v resnici je.
And that's a man.
In to je moški.
And man was created for women.
In moški je bil ustvarjen za žensko.
Now, what disturbs the so-called scientific lobby, homosexual lobby is...
Kaj pa pravi tako pač imenovana znanost, pač ki jo podpira homoseksualni lobby?
As we have thousands of men witnessing to this.
Aha, se pravi, na tisoče mož v bistvu nasprotuje temu, kar pravijo tako imenovani znanstveniki.
They're persecuted, they're bullied, they get death threats.
In prav ti možje, ki pričujejo, da je takšna stvar možna, so preganjeni, dobijo smrtne grožnje in jih se nad njimi izživljajo.
But they're there.
Ampak obstajajo pa.
Okay, I want, if anyone, there's certainly probably someone is who's struggling with homosexuality, I use the method of Courage International.
Tukaj je gotovo kdo, ki se pač bori s homoseksualnostjo, uporablja metodo organizacije, ki se imenuje Courage International, se pravi
It's an NGO, a Catholic NGO in America that works with men like that.
Gre za, se pravi, krščansko nevladno organizacijo, katoliško nevladno organizacijo, ki se v Združenih državah ukvarja s tovrstnimi
So you can Google Courage International.
Torej, če hočete pogledati, lahko napišete v Google Courage International.
Now, is someone born like that?
Torej, ali je človek rojen s tovrstnimi nagnjeni?
I don't know.
Ne vem.
But I don't care.
Pa me v bistvu tudi ne briga.
Because we have conception before birth.
Ker imamo pred rojstvom tudi spočetje.
Now, is someone conceived like that?
Ali je človek spočet na ta način?
I don't know.
Tega tudi ne vem.
And science doesn't know.
Ampak tega tudi znanost
And that's
ne ve.
The truth. Science does not know the cause of homosexuality.
To je dejstvo. Znanost ne ve, v čem leži vzrok homoseksualnosti.
Now,
zdaj pa,
if someone says, well, you know, people are born that way and they're that way, that means it's good. Well, you know, then all of our prisons would be empty.
Torej, če pa nekdo reče, glejte, ker se ljudje tako rodijo, to pomeni, da je to dobra stvar, to bi pomenilo, da bi bili tudi vsi naši zapori prazni.
I knew an arsonist.
Poznal je nekoga, ki je bil požigalec.
Great man.
Ful dober človek.
He just liked fire.
Ogen je tudi zelo fajn stvar in on ga je pač rad prežigal.
He liked to light fires.
Bilo mu je všeč.
But he's a good guy.
Ampak v resnici je bil zelo dober fant.
He says he's born that way.
Prav, da se je tak že rodil.
There's a lot of other things going on. I know guys who love pregnant women. He's got a wife, but he has a fetish on pregnant women. He says he's always loved pregnant women.
Poznam fanta, ki ima fetiš na noseče ženske. Ima ženo, je poročen, ampak prav, da njem so od nekdaj bile všeč nosečnice.
Okay, listen. The born that way argument.
Ta argument, da je bil nekdo tak pač rojen,
is so pathetic.
Je tak beden,
because I could justify anything I want.
Ker lahko z njim upravičiš kar kol se ti sprne.
And mark my words.
In zapomnite si.
Mark my words.
Ja, zapomnite si.
Pedophilia is next on the list.
Kako?
Pedophilia and incest is next on the list.
Pedofilija in incest sta naslednja v vrsti stvari, ki jih bojo skušali spraviti skozi.
Sorry, within 10 years, polygamy.
Žal mi je, ne, v naslednjih 10 letih bo šlo za poligamijo.
Then incest.
Potem incest.
Then pedophilia.
In potem pedofilija.
Then bestiality.
In potem zoofilstvo, se pravi.
Call me in 10 years and we'll see what's going on.
Pokličte me čez 10 let, pa bomo videli, o čem se bomo pogovarjali takrat.
We're born that way.
Se smo rojeni na ta način.
So where do we pull the line?
Kje bomo torej potegnili črto?
Where do we pull the line that we're born that way?
Kje smo torej pripravljeni potegniti črto, ko še dovolimo, da smo pač rojeni tako ali pa nismo?
Okay, listen, one more thing about the whole argument with homosexuals and the homosexual lobby. One more thing.
Še ena stvar o tem pred celotnem prepiru s homoseksualnim lobijem.
Our problem is,
naša težava je o tem,
we lost the war of vocabulary.
Da smo zgubili vojno s slovarjem.
Because, you know, let me tell you something.
Ne vam nekaj povem.
I am not a heterosexual.
Jaz nisem heteroseksualec.
I'm a man.
Jaz sem moški.
Those are constructs.
To, tukaj gre za ene konstrukte.
Those words, homosexual, asexual, bisexual, transsexual, are words that were invented.
Tukaj gre za konstrukte, gre za besede, ki so bile izumljene
in the last 100 years.
V zadnjih 100 letih.
And what they do is this, very interesting.
In z njimi naredijo takole, poglejte,
they take the word sex,
vzamajo besedo sex,
that has no meaning at all,
ki v bistvu sploh nima nobenega
pomena. And they put any prefix they want before it,
in pred njo dodajo katerokoli predpono,
and they give meaning to sex.
In dajo s tem spolnosti nek
pomen. So you got heterosexual, bisexual, asexual, polysexual, transsexual, homosexual. So sex doesn't mean anything, but what you think it's Descartes, what I am, I think, therefore I am. So whatever I think, that will be. Well, that's... Okay, sorry about that.
Razumeli, ne? Okay. Se pravi, imamo vse te možne heteroseksualce, biseksualce, aseksualce in tako naprej. In s tem, ko si zamislimo tak koncept, tisti koncept tudi določi mene samega, ker s tem, ko si jaz to zamislim, ne,
okay,
mislim torej sem s tem, ko jaz postavim
jaz. To say that someone is a homosexual or a heterosexual,
če torej rečemo, da je nekdo homoseksualec ali pa heteroseksualec,
is to reduce my identity,
je v bistvu s tem reduciramo našo identiteto,
to what I would do with my genitals,
na to, kar bom jaz pač počel s svojimi genitalijami.
That's disgraceful.
V bistvu je to sramotno.
I am more,
jaz sem precej več,
than what I want to do with my genitals.
Kot pa tisto, kar želim početi s svojimi genitalijami.
How can you form a whole identity on the basis of what you would do with your genitals?
Kako lahko svojo celotno identiteto ustvariš na podlagi tega, kar pač želiš početi s svojimi spolnimi organi?
For me,
zame torej,
there is man and woman, period.
Obstajata moški in ženska in pika.
And what I tell men with the homosexual tendency, that's the language I use.
Se pravi, uporabljam pa jezik takšen, ne? Kaj povem možem, ki imajo homoseksualna nagnjenja?
Become what you are.
Postani to, kar že si.
That's what I do with them.
To jim povem.
I encourage them.
Moški.
I pray over them.
Moški. Izpodbuja, zanje moli.
And I try to be a donkey. I bring Jesus to them.
In skušam biti osliček, ki prinaša Jezusa.
I have no stress.
In ob tem pač nisem zaskrbljen.
Because Jesus is going to do what he wants.
Ker Jezus lahko v življenju tega osebe stori, kar on želi.
If he encounters the living Jesus, resurrected Christ,
če ta oseba sreča živega, ostalega Kristusa,
he will not have any problems.
Ne bo imel več težav.
If God allows the tendency of homosexuality to stay with him,
če Bog dovoli, da pri njem ta nagnjenost ostane in ustraja,
he will be in the first circle of the concentric circles around the Holy Trinity in heaven. I guarantee that.
Bo ta oseba, ki se temu zoprstavi v prvem krogu v nebesih, se pravi najbolj blizu Božjemu prestolu.
We are all called to holiness.
Vsi smo poklicani k svetosti.
Okay, so was okay. Other question about homosexual?
To je načeloma vse iz te teme.
Okay,
še zadnjo temo odpremo, ker nas čas že kar preganja, in sicer tema naravne metode. Kako v praksi živeti naravno metodo, glede na to, da so čas, moči, potrpežljivost omejeni, še posebej za moške? Oprostite, jaz malo skrajšujem vprašanja.
Okay. Actually, NFP. Okay. Natural family planning. Okay.
Pravi naravno načrtovanje družine, v redu?
Okay. You know, woman, dear sisters in Christ,
drage sestre v Kristu,
you gotta know who invented the pill.
Vedeti morate, kdo je izumil tabletko.
Men invented the pill.
Moški so izumili tabletko.
Not women.
Ne ženske.
Because we, men in the 1950s, French and American pharmacists,
ker v 50-ih letih 20. stoletja so francoski in ameriški farmacevti
invented the pill,
izumili tabletko,
to give to women,
ki bi jo pač želeli dati ženskam.
Because for men it was difficult to they gave the pill to women because their cycle and their body was too confusing.
Se pravi, tabletko so dali ženskam zato, ker je bil pač njihov cikl in njihovo telo čist preveč zakomplicirano za njih.
And the funny part about it is,
in smešen del tega vsega skupaj je,
it was given to women in the 50s and 60s,
je, da so to dali ženskam v 50-ih in 60-ih letih,
in a sense that it's gonna liberate you,
na način, ki jim je obljubljal, da jih bo osvobodil.
The only people who are liberated,
in edini ljudje, ki so pa v resnici osvobojeni,
are men. Liberated from responsibility.
Pa so možje, ker so osvobojeni svojih odgovornosti.
Force him, make him, teach him to learn your cycles and he'll respect you more.
Prisilite jih, naučite jih, pripravite jih do tega, da se bojo naučili vaš, kakšen je vaš cikl in
if,
oni vas bodo zaradi tega še bolj spoštovali.
If you let him get it whenever he wants, however he wants, you will have an addict.
Če pustiš, da tvoj dec dobi kadar če, pa kolikor če, boš iz njega naredila se pravi odvisnika.
Now, I have a lot of couples that I married.
Imam veliko parov, ki jih je pač poročil.
That live NFP.
Ki živijo po tej naravni metodi.
Peter is married. There he is.
Peter je poročen.
He lives NFP with his wife. He could talk. It's maybe be better if he talks to you instead of me.
Mogoče bi bilo bolje, da bi on kaj o tem povedal.
But you know, let me tell you something about abstinence.
Ampak ženska, naj vam nekaj povem o abstinenci, ob se pravi o tem,
no,
da se
it could be very healthy for a marriage, you know?
Veste, to je lahko zelo zdrava stvar za nek zakon.
Because you know what happens to a man's heart when he abstains?
Ker veste, kaj se zgodi z moškim srcem, kadar se mora od česa vzdržati?
He struggles.
S tem se bori.
He contains himself.
Se mora zadrževati.
And he learns how to desire again.
In ponovno se želi, se nauči, kako želeti, kako si želeti.
I think that's great.
In meni se zdi, da je tukaj nekaj zelo lepega in zelo fajnega.
And you know what NFP makes him do?
In veste, kaj povzroči v njih ta naravna metoda?
It makes him learn about you in totality.
Tudi o vas se mora zaradi nje on poučiti in to poučiti do konca.
See, we guys,
vete, mi fantje,
we usually see this.
Mi ponavadi vidimo samo to, ne?
But we don't see what's inside.
Ne vidimo pa tega, kar je znotraj.
When was the last time you heard a guy say, "Oh wow, man, she's going through ovulation."
Daj si nazadnje slišal kakšnega moškega.
Oh, she's ovulating. Oh,
pismo letale, ima pa zdaj ovulacijo.
Okay. But you know, ovulation is a part of your process.
Ampak ovulacija je del procesa, skozi katerega greste.
And it's natural.
In gre za nekaj naravnega.
I can't believe that I have to prove to people that that which is natural is good.
Ne morem verjeti, da je treba ljudem danes dokazovati, da je to, kar se zgodi samo po sebi naravno, nekaj dobrega.
It's like, what's going on, man?
Mislim, halo, kaj se dogaja?
We're all about natural.
Vsi ves čas hočemo samo naravne stvari.
So we want natural water, we want natural potatoes, we want natural tomatoes, we want natural everything.
Hočemo naravne paradajze, naravne krompir, naravno vse.
So in Paris, all the presidents are in Paris and they're talking about ecology and the nature.
Se pravi, v Parizu se vsi predsedniki držav pogovarjajo o naravi in o ekologiji.
So Bill Gates is talking about it, George Soros is talking about it, and Zuckerberg is talking about it, and all these guys are talking about nature and ecology and the Green Party.
Bill Gates, Zuckerberg, Soros, vsi govorijo o tem, ves čas, o zeleni stranki, o naravnih stvarih.
But when it comes to sex,
kadar pa pride do spolnosti,
and then we're talking about rubber, about lubricants, about pills, what's going on? Why aren't we natural here, man?
Takrat pa začnemo govoriti o gumi, o lubrikantih, o tabletah, zakaj pa tle nismo naravni?
Because they're all liars.
Zaradi tega, ker so v resnici vsi
they're all oni liars. Lžnici. All of them are they're lying, they're people of the lie.
Oni so ljudje laži, lažejo. Vsi po vrsti.
Can't you see through it?
A tega ne morete videti.
Can't you see through the lies?
A se tega ne da videti. Vidi se skozi laži.
Look at any green party. There probably is a green party in Slovenia. We have a green party in Croatia, okay? They're called Orah.
Tudi na Hrvaškem imajo zeleno stranko zelenih, pri nas so malo propadli, ne?
And they're all about nature.
In oni vsi govorijo o naravi.
But when it comes to sex,
ampak ko pride pa do spolnosti,
it's all artificial.
Gre pa za samo za vse, kar je umetnega.
Contraception,
kontracepcija,
abortion,
splav,
sterilization.
Sterilizacija.
What's going on, man?
Kaj se tu dogaja?
Like, how can we be so stupid?
Kako smo lahko tako butasti?
Like, I can't believe I have to prove to someone that contraception is no good.
Ne morem verjeti, da je treba komorkoli sploh dokazovati, da kontracepcija ni nekaj dobro.
That's how crazy this world is.
Tako je svet danes nor.
Woman, it's just not natural, man. It's not part. You're putting something in your cycle that's totally messing up your nature.
Žene, pač tukaj gre za nekaj res, v svoj cikel ustavljate nekaj, kar popolnoma zmeša vaše naravne danosti.
Why do we have to prove something to you?
Zakaj je treba tukaj sploh karkoli dokazovati?
Can't you see?
A ne vidite tega same?
Just think about it a little. No, just think logically, okay?
Dejmo, prosim,
let's leave God and theology out.
Pustimo Boga pa teologijo za en čas ob strani pa poskušimo samo logično razmišljati.
It's not natural.
To ni naravno.
And that's it.
In to je to.
Now I could talk about theology.
Seveda potem pa lahko spregovorimo tudi
we're Catholic here.
O teologiji, če predvidevamo, da ste tukaj katoličani.
You guys saw the Holy Trinity, the communion of persons?
Se ste videli Sveto Trojico in to skupnost oseb.
Okay, so what does contraception do?
Kaj torej naredi kontracepcija?
So when husband and wife make love,
ko se torej mož in žena ljubita,
they partake in the inner life of the Holy Trinity.
S tem sodelujeta v notranjem življenju Svete Trojice.
And what does contraception do?
In kaj stori kontracepcija?
So, you wanna make love with your wife?
Se želite ljubiti svojo ženo?
But God is life and love.
Ampak Bog je tisti, ki je ljubezen in ki je življenje.
So basically you're telling God.
In v bistvu s tem, ko uporabljate kontracepcijo, rečete Bogu,
stay out.
Ostani zunaj.
And that's not a true image of the Trinitarian love.
In pri takem spolnem odnosu ne gre za resnično podobo trinitarične ljubezni.
Now that's theology.
Tukaj je zraven pa še teologija.
Okay, let's talk about NFP.
Pa se pogovorimo še malo o naravni metodi.
So you got a couple?
Imamo tukaj en par.
That does not want to have a child. Maybe they have 2, 3, 4. Maybe they have one child, but they feel in their freedom that they can't have any more children. Thank God, they have a right to that. Humane Vitae says that.
Torej, par, ki pravi, morda ima enega, dva, tri, štiri otrok, tudi če ima samo enega, pa se čuti, da ne bi mogel imeti več otrok, je to njuna pravica, njuna svobodna odločitev. Tudi Humane Vitae, ta okrožnica Pavla VI. Govori o tem.
Okay, so you don't have to have 15 children.
Ni vam torej treba imeti 15 otrok, če ste katoličani.
Okay. Responsible parenthood is a Catholic idea.
Odgovorno starševstvo je v bistvu katoliška okay. zamisel.
So we have one couple A and couple B.
Imamo torej tu par A in par B.
Couple A,
par A
does not want to have children anymore.
Si več ne želi imeti otrok.
Because of financial, emotional, psychological reasons.
Iz čistih finančnih, čustvenih, psiholoških razlogov.
That's okay.
In to je okay.
Couple B, same thing. They have one or two children, they don't want to have, they can't have children because of financial, emotional, psychological reasons.
In tudi par B ima na primer dva otroka in si ne želi več imeti otrok iz istih razlogov, finančnih, čustvenih, kakršnih koli že.
Couple A says, Lord, thank you for my wife and husband, thank you for our marriage.
Par A pravi, Gospod Bog, hvala ti za najin zakon,
we
za moža, za ženo.
We can't have children anymore.
midva res ne morava več imeti otrok.
But we have such a need to make love to each other.
Ampak seveda se pa želiva ljubiti
drugega. Because it reinforces our sacraments.
Ker s tem utrjujeva svojo zakramentalno ljubezen.
Lord, thank you for my wife's cycle.
Gospod, hvala ti za ženin cikl.
Where I have fertile and infertile days.
V katerem imamo plodne in neplodne dni.
I will make love to my wife.
Z ženo se želim ljubiti.
And that my sexual act will be free, total.
In s tem bo moje spolno dejanje svobodno, totalno, popolno.
And Lord, I will make love to my wife in these infertile days that you gave her.
In Gospod, z ženo se bom ljubil v teh neplodnih dneh, ki si jih ti daroval.
And God, if you say let it be.
In Bog, če boš ti rekel, da naj bo še en otrok.
Thank God.
V redu, hvala
so
Bogu. Hvala ti, naj bo.
So be it.
Pa naj bo.
Amen.
Amen.
That is called open to life.
Temu pravimo, da je človek odprt
življenju. By using NFP.
S tem, ko uporablja naravno metodo.
Couple B.
Par B.
Says same thing. God, we don't want, we can't have children emotionally. But God, if you dare say let it be, I'm not going to let you because I'm going to put a barrier between me and my wife. So don't you mess with my what I'm doing in bed.
Pravi, glej, Bog, ne drzen si še kakšnega otroka nama dati, ne? Ker ti tega ne dovolim, bom med naju z ženo v postelji dal pač pregrado.
This couple allows God to be God.
Ta par prvi A dovoljuje Bogu, da je Bog.
This couple doesn't.
Ta drugi par pa se tega, pa mu tega ne dovoli.
The difference.
Razlika.
Is cosmic.
Pa je enormna, ogromna.
Okay. I want you to pray about that.
Vabim vas, da o tem molite.
Okay. And you know, a lot of couples that practice NFP.
Veste, veliko parov, ki živi in prakticira to naravno metodo.
Witness.
Pričuje.
That their love grows.
Zato, da njihova ljubezen raste.
Respect.
Skozi spoštovanje drug do drugega.
I'm not here to point fingers at people that use contraception.
Se pravi, tukaj nismo zato, da bi s prstom kazali na ljudi, ki uporabljajo kontracepcijo.
Because I know about 90% of Catholics use contraception.
Ker vem, da približno 90% katoličanov uporablja kontracepcijo.
But I don't care about democracy.
Ampak meni tukaj ne gre za demokracijo.
And majority thinking.
In za razmišljanje o tem, kaj dela večina.
I care about the truth.
Mene tukaj zanima resnica.
That's why I proclaim the truth.
Zato to resnico tudi proglašam.
So I want all couples to try.
Zato si želim, da prav vsi pari poizkusite.
I still haven't seen that someone died trying.
Nisem videl, da bi kdorkoli kdaj umrl zaradi poizkušanja.
But I have seen marriages invigorated.
Ampak videl sem pa zakone, ki so šli na razen.
Try it.
Kaj? Aha, poživljeni, aja, sorry.
Yeah, okay.
Se pravi, ki so šli na razni zaradi unga, sem mislil, ampak ja, okay.
Okay. And also, one other thing, I read somewhere, because there's something called the biology of the theology of the body.
Okay. Obstaja tudi stvar, ki se ji reče biologija teologije telesa.
I read somewhere that sperm
in nekje sem bral to, da
has antidepressants in it.
Da ima sperma, moška sperma v sebi antidepresivna antidepresive.
Yeah, guys, husbands,
možje,
don't withhold your sperm from your wife.
Ne prikrajšajte svoji žena za svojo spermo.
Those are antidepressants.
V njej so tudi antidepresivna telesca, na nek način.
Yeah, man.
Snovi.
That's what I call ecological green sex.
In temu pravimo ekološki zeleni seks.
See, the Catholic Church is totally natural, man.
Katoliška cerkev je popolnoma naravna.
Yeah. Okay, let's go on.
Okay. No, in s to zanimivo mislijo,
sorry,
današnji večer.
I have one more thing. Listen.
Še nekaj bi rad povedal.
I want to say one more thing.
Še nekaj bi rad povedal.
This is very deeply spiritual what I'm going to say, okay?
Rad bi povedal nekaj, kar je v osnovi zelo globoka duhovna resnica.
I've heard about, some people have spoken to me about being the fruit of contraceptive sex.
Slišal sem že pričevanje ljudi, ki so mi govorili o tem, da so bili spočeti v spolnem dejanju, kjer je pač bila prisotna kontracepcija.
You know, the Japanese are doing a lot about prenatal psychology.
In Japonci delajo veliko študij na temo prenatalne psihologije.
And they're not known to be good Catholics.
In Japonci vemo, da niso prav dobri katoličani.
Well, they're not Catholic.
Niso katoličani sploh.
Well, there are Catholics in Japan, but it's like 1%.
So tudi tam katoličani, ampak to gre za 1% ljudi.
It's very interesting what they found out.
In je zelo zanimivo, kaj so odkrili.
That the context of conception.
Odkrili so, da je kontekst, v katerem je človek spočet, se pravi v tistem trenutku,
is very important.
V bistvu je način tega spočetja zelo pomemben.
I would hope,
upam,
that my father,
da sta oče,
when he made love with my mother,
da se je moj oče, ko se je ljubil z mojo materjo,
July 25, 1972, that my father Mate,
da se je moj oče Mate,
told my mother Mara,
je rekel moji materi Mari,
you know, Mara, I love you,
Mara, rad te imam.
I wanna confirm our wedding vows tonight.
In rad bi da nocoj potrdiva svojo zakramentalno zakonsko obljubo.
On the day of our wedding in 1968,
kajti na dan najne poroke leta 1968,
I told you before God,
sem ti pred Bogom obljubil,
that I love you totally,
da te ljubim popolnoma,
faithfully,
zvesto,
freely,
svobodno,
and fruitfully,
in tudi rodovitno.
And I want to tell you that with my body tonight.
In to bi ti rad danes povedal tudi s svojim telesom.
And if God,
in če Bog
proclaims,
izreče,
let it be,
da naj danes bo,
let it be,
naj danes
I will not interfere with God.
Z Bogom, v Božje načrte se ne želim umešavati.
Because I want to have a memento,
ker želim imeti trenutek,
of this evening,
ker si želim nekako zapomeniti, spomin, ja, spomin na tošnjega večera.
That's what Catholic sex is all about.
In to je tisto, čemor je namenjena katoliška spolnost.
Contraception messes everything up.
Kontracepcija v bistvu vse pokvari.
It's a lie.
In tukaj gre za eno laž.
You say totally with the body.
S telesom praviš, da se popolnoma predajaš.
But it's not total.
Ampak če je tukaj zraven kontracepcija, tukaj ne gre za popolno predajo.
That's why it's a lie.
Zato je tu laž.
Please don't get angry at with me.
Prosim, ne se preveč razjeziti name.
Because usually when I speak about these things,
ker kadar o teh stvarih ponovadi govorim,
I see aggressive reactions.
Vidim agresivne reakcije ljudi.
But I want you to think about it and pray about it.
Ampak želim, da o tem zares razmislite in o tem molite.
I can't force you.
Ne moram vas prisiliti.
But the church teaches this teaching.
Ampak ta nauk je nauk cerkve.
Why don't you try to see why and why don't you see if it works?
Poskuste videti, v čem je razlog takšnega nauka in poskuste videti, če to deluje za vas.
Jesus says, taste and see.
Jezus pravi, okusite in spoznajte.
Sorry, in the Old Testament says, taste and see in the Psalms.
Stara zaveza, okay, psalmi pravi.
Let's go ahead.
No, to pa je zdaj mogoče že malo boljši zaključek na našega večera. yeah, that was the last one, because we are over time a lot.
Okay, well, sorry?
Final word.
Okay, wow, the pressure is unbelievable.
Neverjeten pritisk, zadnje besede, ojoj.
Okay, very, very short, one or two sentences.
Čisto na kratko.
When you come before God,
ko človek pride pred Boga,
he will not ask you and he will not judge you.
Ko bomo preden prišli po smrti, nas ne bo
sodil. If you were successful,
in vas ne bo vprašal, a ste bili v življenju uspešni.
He will judge you according to three things.
Sodil pa vas bo po naslednjih treh stvarih.
Were you faithful?
Ali ste bili zvesti?
Were you holy?
Ali ste bili sveti?
And did you hunger and thirst for him?
In ali ste v srcu in življenju imeli željo in žejo po njem?
Blessed are the hungry and thirsty.
Blagoslovljeni so tisti, ki so lačni in žejni.
They will be fulfilled.
Blagor tistim, kaj ti
Jesus did not say, blessed are those who are filled.
Jezus ni rekel blagor tistim, ki so izpolnjeni.
Blessed are hungry and thirsty.
Blagor lačnim in žejnim.
Now listen, that means,
poslušajte, to pomeni,
as long as you fight the battle,
da kolikor dolgo pač človek ustraja v tej bitki,
even if you fall 1000 times,
in če tudi na poti pade 1000-krat,
if you keep fighting,
če ustraja v boju,
you will win heaven.
Bo človek dobil nebesa.
God will not ask you, were you successful?
Bog te na koncu ne bo vprašal, a si bil uspešen.
Only holy and faithful.
A si uspel, ampak samo, a si bil svet in a si bil zvest.
In First Kings.
V prvi knjigi kraljev.
David was dying.
Je David opisuje, kako je David umiral.
And Yahweh told him.
In Bog Jahve mu je rekel.
My servant.
Moj služabnik.
My son.
Moj sin.
You wanted to build a temple for me.
Hotel si mi izgraditi tempel.
But you didn't.
Ampak tega nisi uspel narediti.
It is good.
In to je dobro.
That you wanted to build it.
Dobro je to, da si si to želel storiti.
My faithful servant.
Moj zvesti služabnik.
David was not successful.
David ni uspel v tem svojem
He didn't build a temple.
On nikoli ni zgradil templa.
But he wanted to build a temple.
Imel pa je v sebi to željo.
So I want you all to build a temple of God here on earth.
Zato vam vsem želim in privoščim,
If you're not successful,
da gradite Božji tempel tukaj na zemlji. Če pri tem ne uspete,
don't worry about it.
Ne bodite zaskrbljeni nad tem.
You will be judged.
Sojeno vam bo.
By what you wanted.
Glede na to, kaj ste si želeli.
By your holiness.
Glede na vašo svetost.
And your faithfulness.
In na vašo zvestobo.
Thank you very much.
Hvala lepa.
Zaključili bomo pa tako, kot smo začeli, z molitvijo in pa z blagoslovom.
Okay, I want you all to stand.
Vabim vas, da ostanete.
Okay, we're gonna sing a song that maybe some of you know. In Brazil, World Youth Day, a couple of years ago.
Zapeli bomo pesem, ki jo morda nekateri poznate. Bila je pesem svetovnega dneva mladih v Braziliji.
We heard a beautiful song that was sung before the Blessed Sacrament.
In tam smo z njo počastili evharistično navzočnost Jezusa.
It was written by my fellow Canadian Matt Mayer.
Napisal jo je Kanadčan Matt Mayer.
And it's called Lord, I Need You.
In imenuje se Gospod, potrebujem te.
Because everything I said tonight,
vse, kar sem nocoj izrekel,
you need the Lord.
Je v bistvu zaobseženo v tej besedi, da človek potrebuje Gospoda.
In the Bible, whenever an angel appears to someone,
kadarkoli se v Svetem pismu angel pojavi pred nekom,
the angel says, the Lord be with you.
Pravi, Gospod s teboj.
That appears seven times in the Bible.
To se v Svetem pismu pojavi sedemkrat.
And that's why when the angel Gabriel told Mary, the Lord be with you,
in zato tudi, ko je angel Gabriel rekel Mariji, Gospod s teboj,
she was shocked.
Je bila šokirana.
Because she knew.
Kaj ti vedela je,
that was only told to people.
Da je bilo v preteklosti to rečeno samo ljudem,
who had to do great things in the Bible.
Ki so imeli za Boga opraviti veliko
stvari. Moses, Abraham, Samuel.
Mojzes, Abraham, Samuel.
That was not a regular way to say hi to someone.
Ni šlo za nek navaden pozdrav, ki bi ga rekomu rekel tako.
That was a salutation from heaven to an earthly person.
Šlo je za izrecen pozdrav iz nebes nekomu tukaj na zemlji.
To do big things.
Ki so mu bile naročene velike stvari.
In the mass we say the Lord be with you four times.
In tudi pri sveti maši štirikrat rečemo Gospod s teboj.
Especially at the end, the Lord be with you.
Gospod z vami, rečemo čisto na koncu svete maše.
Because you have to go out and do great things for the Lord.
Ker moramo iti iz cerkve ven in storiti velike reči za Gospoda.
And you cannot do that without the Lord.
In brez Gospoda.
That's why we're going to end with the Lord be with you. We're going to sing Lord, I need you.
In zato okay. bomo tudi nocoj zaključili s to pesmijo, ki pravi Gospod, potrebujem te, da si z menoj.
After we sing a couple of verses,
in ko bomo zapeli nekaj prvih uvodnih vrstic,
I will pray over all of you,
bi rad molil nad vsemi
vami blessing.
In dal blagoslov.
Lord, I need you.
Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense,
my righteousness.
Oh God, how I need you.
Lord Jesus Christ. You are the Alpha and Omega, my personal Savior and Lord. We need you, Lord Jesus Christ, because we have darkness in our hearts. I pray, Lord Jesus Christ, eradicate all sin, all weakness, all darkness from all of our hearts. Lord Jesus Christ, look down upon us and liberate every person from the spirit of lust, from the spirit of fornicating. Lord Jesus Christ, I offer up to you those who are victims of other people's lusts, those who are weak, those who have been victimized in their childhood, those who have been exposed to lust and pornography. Lord Jesus Christ, you are Savior and Lord, you are healer of mind, body, and soul. Heal these people, Lord Jesus Christ. Touch their hearts, heal their hearts, give them deliverance from all evil. Lord, we need you because we cannot live without you. Lord Jesus Christ, you said that you are the vine, the branch. Reside in us, Lord Jesus Christ, because we need you. Lord, I need you. Sad ćemo ovo na hrvatskom pjevati, a vi možete onda prevesti na slovenskom, ok? Možete jednom na hrvatskom, pa ćete na slovenskom ovo prevesti. Evo ga, na hrvatskom jednom.
Gospode, ja tako trebam. Gospode, ja tako trebam.
Lord Jesus Christ, I thank you for this encounter, for every person that you brought here tonight. I place them all under the protection of your sacred heart and your precious blood. Mary, our mother, intercede for us before your son. Protect us and guide us. Lord Jesus Christ, thank you for your glory. Thank you for bringing me here tonight. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, for all graces and healings that happen tonight. Bless this place. Bless all these people, their families. Bless this country. Lord, bless this holy land where so many people spilled their blood for the faith. Lord Jesus Christ, affirm them in their faith so that they may be holy and faithful to you. Slava Otcu. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.